So here we are today cleaning one of our commercial dumpster pads. And this pad is actually underneath the embassy here. It actually services this whole commercial strip. There are like six restaurants here. Well, if you can see all the way down here, the trees. No, you can't even see the end of it, but it goes down about a couple blocks that way, and it services all the restaurants in here. Everything from a Ruth Chris, a Starbucks, another steakhouse, about four or five other restaurants. And you never know, it's a monthly service. Sometimes it's bad and sometimes it's not too bad, but you'll see. And what we have to do is come in here. Let's see how bad it looks. Oh, not too bad. They actually put the cardboard over there. It used to be in this room too, and that was a mess. They service the cardboard waste there. You see where they bring it down underneath this garage here, multi-story garage underneath. This is the entrance to the trash room. And it's always an excitement when you open it, see how bad it is. Hopefully. Not too bad. All the debris, they actually sent a crew in the day before we come to pick up all the trash. What happens, the older guys that work in the daytime are pretty good about putting the dumpster. Get the young guys working at night, they don't care, they dump that crap anywhere. See the grease, one of the grease vats. Nice, looks good underneath here, right? Actually not too bad. And you got another grease one over here that gets, as you can see the top of it there, looks nice and appetizing. Smells real good in here too. So we're gonna get started here in just a second. I'll show you the first thing we do. What we're gonna do, I've got one of these Ryobi sprayers. It's real handy for things. Ain't that about 500 to 600 square feet of spray. It's good for putting down a real strong mix. I'll downstream a mix using EBC, and with this, what we're gonna do is mix 1 gallon of EBC and about 3 gallons of water. And you're gonna see I'm just gonna pre-spray the real bad parts, let it be working while we finish setting up. And then I'll downstream it and then we'll start cleaning. Fun. All kind of dumpsters, you know, sometimes in an office building it'd just be big paper dumpsters, maybe one little restaurant. But these aren't your typical dumpsters you find at fast food restaurants, you know, little 10 by 10 places that tend to be pretty dirty. So big commercial ones, I like to be an office building where it's just big, truly big trash rooms. Here they've got a couple of trash rooms, and then this is the main primary for. Now here's my little Ryobi. You just hit the really stuff. I just dump. Comes about 25 feet of hose or something. I just dump it in there. Take it a minute. Take a minute. Pull it through all the hose. Like I said, I'm putting down EBC about a gallon. I'm putting down a little bit stronger than a downstream mix, just on the really bad parts. See, we have to do all the way out here too. All the way out there. This isn't bad here, either the downstream hit. And you'll see when you come back, it eats this stuff up pretty good. Jaden, you got a hose pulled? No, it's not there. Oh boy, see all the flies flying around. Smells really good here. That, I'm sorry, this is a monthly. It's about 4.5 weeks. Let's see. While this is sitting, put a heavier coat on. Big electrical panel always makes it exciting. See, out there we got a snake around a pig around that drain out there. And we put another one around our outside drain. I say it doesn't take long with this thing. See how it's already breaking that grease down? Go ahead and get this paper and stuff up out here. Yeah, I got a little bit of my little use the rest of it. Well, that was about 4 gallons total. This thing goes pretty far, this little sprayer. They have a crew come in just to clean up all the scrap stuff before we actually come in. So those little things are handy though for small areas. Put down instead of having to X-jet or pump spray it or something like that. Knock it out pretty quick. EBC here. That there, down in there. Initially, we're putting out the soap because I set the temperature at about 130, 125, 130. You don't want it too hot. Sometimes that'll break down your soap and stuff like that, certain chemicals. Once we actually start cleaning, it'll bump it up to about 175, 180. So. And you see here where this stuff's starting to break it down some already. flushing out soaps and job yesterday. Here we go. We'll be all the way out today. Okay, move that sock around a little bit because it runs in the back side. Just slide it around about a foot. Yeah, that's good. Look at how dirty that stuff is already. Coming up. The wires have the right tools. There's just even a little bit of heat out there starting to break it down. Hey, how you doing?
Good. Yeah, I thought you'd put my cut there. Y'all doing a good job, man. Let me get out of here. Y'all won't see me no more.
No problem.
I wasn't even pulling up a working man.
No problem.
Man, y'all stay down as fast as you can.
You too. Hey, move that shovel and stuff. Where are your gloves? Put it over here in the thing over here. I'd set them over there. Oh. Gotta get the walls. We'll move as we start cleaning. Uniform dumpster. Oh, this will look nice and right this morning. We got to clean the top of it, but they got a little crap over it. Oh boy, tasty. Yeah, I'll put the soap, the heat, Well, I'm saying the EBC's been good. Well, we're down here, we have to be careful what we put. We have to be careful what we put. We got a, over there, just right over that walkway there, is a major river. It goes, flows through downtown and stuff like that. So we have to be real careful. This all goes to the sewer system, but okay, Jayden, make sure the machine's all the way up and cut it up about 175 on the heat. We're ready to get started here. I always let Jayden do this part. And notice we'll start right in here too, because this flows out here. And we'll do this area out here. You got your gloves? It's hot.
You think I need another one?
Well, anybody wants your regular one. But... he's going to play this. And notice when he gets over here where the cars are, he's not going to ever turn his back to the cars. Maybe playing commercial, even commercial like drive-throughs or restaurants. I've seen them drive over cones and everything else. So always keep kind of face the traffic anytime you might be in a danger area. Because they'll ignore them even during off hours. I mean, it'd be 2 hours before they open at 8 o'clock in the morning or something. These churches come driving through the drive-through. When you try to clean it. Clean that stuff up. See the difference? Okay, we're running about 175, maybe 180. I think it runs a little hot. Good sober, he usually one good pass is enough. And generally, you don't really typically gain a whole lot by going multiple passes. Sometimes we will. Go ahead and do a round over there and do that section, and we'll do this. People coming in here. They like for us to keep this clean to what happened. The city owns the garage. And you got a bunch of grease out here, you see it extracts it all the way on around. You see that grease coming from there. There's another room up there we do that the delivery for the food delivery for about four different restaurants. And it gets really nasty too. We only clean it though every quarter. And but you see when people walking out of there and breaking down their carts and stuff. Leave it down here, but we have to clean this up. See the difference? Heat makes a whole lot of difference. You can't do these without heat. But you can see this stuff, it starts to break down the grease. That you know, a lot of good degrees with EBC, though, especially in my in-town stuff and everything. Just environmentally, it does a great job. One more time, they do your outline down that line over there. Yeah, see, it's busy in here. Almost lunch. Oh. Go down that line over there and get your outline down there. Well, see, you can. Grand Central Station. Yeah, this is a huge, huge complex. I mean, it's like, actually probably about three city blocks. This is one of the garage entrances. It goes down that way probably, 400 or 500 yards. Yeah, the snakes we use are called pigs. Pig place. They're pretty reasonable. They do a good job. And they're reusable. Only time I wear gloves usually when I'm dealing with heat, especially that nozzle. You go to rinse, it's real hot. Plus I cut myself. Yes, about my hand, because I got a rubber glove on. You just go back and forth this way if you want to. It doesn't matter. Be easier on the hose. All right, just go sideways and sideways. That's good, Yardley. No, Jay, facing that way, back and forth that way. Just turn it, go side to side. Go side to side while you're walking back and forth.
I don't want to walk sideways.
Well, it's like three steps, dude. At least you're not fighting the hose that way. Okay, I'm going to rinse this and we'll get started inside. There are four or five big condo developments above here too. The residents is always glad to see us come here and clean this. They don't get all of their cars either. Okay. A lot different in it. Also, if you use hot water, like these little red guards at the end of the hose, these heavy thick ones, they're made for hot water. And those are a lot easier when you rinse. Holding the hose. Thank you. water. We might be out of water, dude. The water's pretty good here. Time out while we check on that. We hook it up direct and bypass the reel. The use of it's good, we don't have to. 5 minute pause to let the water refill. We didn't hook it up direct. We came with low water this morning. Sometimes you use the side of your surface cleaner where it hits a lot, get some of this stuff up, it's stuck. That's true when you're doing gum too, popping gum. Get that water that hot, you kind of hold it over you. Down there and get some of that trash out of the way. Go to the driveway, keep some of that trash in your rinse in the bottom section. Keep some of that trash out of the way so you get a better clean. Drugs to spit. It doesn't smell quite so bad in here. Get those cats. Right necessary. Go up there a little bit more soap. Purpose to it. Every time you clean a place, you learn something. Yeah, let me get that in the slot, James. A bottle cap action. I've got to pull out of her. Smelling part right in here, right on the screen. You usually I wash off the top of the grease trap, but not today. Grease trap, people will love that when they come to pick that one up. Drained right over there, but it don't work real well, as you can see. But most of it runs out here, so we use a hose, kind of a little bit of berm, catch most of the trash, and then we'll sweep it up, shovel it. Bring that broom too, Joe. Oh, that little one, they got a new one, it looks pretty good. hose over against the dumpster now. Have to be careful when you put that soap where the grease was, it gets real slick. it's hot here. This heat. Up the inside part, so we clean this up, and then we clean outside here where you see the white lines. We clean all this area, give the water time to drain a little bit. We're gonna get up all this trash, then we'll clean that section, and it'll be a wrap. Lower it down. So, like I said, this is one of the dirtiest ones we do. Well, not the dirtiest, but one of the dirtiest ones. And it's just mainly because of high volume. So if you got a high volume one, it's going to be, just gets dirtier. So here we go. Done for this time. It's pretty good. Also, it's not new. Grease is gone. You can actually walk in here without breaking your neck. All this is cleaned out here. It's a wrap. Hope this helps. Tips and stuff. The EBC soap does a great job on this. Cleans it up pretty good. It dries out and looks a lot better. It's still wet now. Actually, lightens up a lot once it dries out. Okay, take care, guys.